Hi, I'm Nick Bonaker, and I'm a graduate student at MIT. My research focuses on an assistive technology interface called nomon, which uses Bayesian methods to facilitate computer interaction for people with near-complete paralysis. I have been working on nomon with an awesome team, including Dr. Emli-Mari in South Africa, Professor Keith Vertanen at Michigan Tech, and Professor Tamara Broderick at MIT. So first, some background on our target population and single switch communication. Individuals with severe motor impairments, such as cerebral palsy or Lockton syndrome, often are completely paralyzed except for a few motor groups. They may be able to, say, raise an eyebrow, breathe, or blink on command. Specialized devices called single switches can detect these activations and relay them to a computer interface. For example, here you can see a person use a sip puff switch designed to detect their breaths. The goal of a single switch interface is to allow an individual to interact with a computer using solely the activation time of their single switch. As a note, these switches cannot express hold duration or release timing, as would be required for methods such as Morse code. With this very limited form of input, the problem becomes, how do we efficiently facilitate complex interactions such as browsing a computer, composing text, or gaming? I'll show the results of our recent user study and how nomon, our single switch interface, can facilitate fast and flexible computer interaction by leveraging Bayesian methods. Profound scanning is a popular interface among single switch users. The interface allows users to select from a grid of options as it progressively scans through them in row column order. For text entry, the grid is filled with letters and word completions that allow them to type. However, there are a few limitations that arise from this method. Firstly, options must be arranged in a grid. This poses a problem for tasks that are not grid-like in nature. For example, browsing the web, choosing among files, or playing a game. Secondly, row column scanning has no built-in error tolerance. Single switch users often have a fair amount of noise in their activation times, and even just activating their switch can be arduous. For these reasons, making and correcting errors poses a large burden for single switch users. And lastly, the selection time does not scale well as the number of options increase. Lots of dead time can accrue as users wait to scan through long lists of options. This poses a barrier to tasks that require a large number of options, such as computer navigation and gaming. Our selection method, nomon, is designed to facilitate fast and flexible selection with a single switch. And it directly addresses these limitations through its Bayesian-based selection scheme. So nomon works a bit differently than row column scanning. It uses plots to indicate selection options. I first find the option I want to select, and I look at the plot to its left. Here, I want to select the letter B, so I'm looking at the clock to its left. I select this clock by activating my switch or clicking when the minute hand passes a red noon line. And that'll be right about now. Notice how the A and C clocks turn black. Nomon highlights its best guesses for the clocks you're going for in blue. And clocks are narrowed down over multiple switch presses or clicks as more clocks turn black. So I'll press again on the B clock. When the software is confident in my desired clock, it makes a selection. In this case, the B clock is the only remaining blue clock, so it was selected. The number of clicks needed to make a selection can vary. The number is determined by my precision in clicking when the minute hand passes noon on my desired clock. In a keyboard application, options extend to include characters and word completions that facilitate typing. We have a demo of our keyboard application available here, and we encourage you to try it out. One of the benefits of this clock mechanism is that it allows flexibility in the layout of the options. They are no longer restricted to a grid, as with row column scanning. This flexibility opens up the possibility for tasks that cannot be placed in a grid, such as navigating a Google search page, like you see here. Nomon swatch to be placed to the left of every selectable option on the page, essentially making the entire website accessible to a single switch. Nomon employs a Bayesian selection method. This method is the basis of how Nomon allows arbitrary ordering of options, compensates for noise and switch inputs, and scales efficiently with large numbers of options. The goal is to predict which slot C the user wants to select, given their observed click times, T. We do this by finding the clock C that maximizes the posterior probability and is above a certain threshold. We can calculate this posterior probability using Bayes' rule. We start by calculating the prior distribution. This is a measure of how likely is a user to choose clock C right off the bat. Priors are often application specific. For example, in a keyboard application of Nomon, we use a language model to determine how probable the next character is given what the user just typed. You can imagine if the user has written H-E-L-L, the probability that the next letter is an O is much higher than a W. The next component needed to compute the posterior distribution is the likelihood function. The likelihood function measures how likely are the user's click times, assuming they targeted clock C. This function is different for each user, and we estimate it in real time based on the user's clicking history. Estimating this function for each user provides Nomon with a built-in tolerance for input error. To visualize this, imagine taking the perimeter of one of the clocks and unwrapping it around the x-axis. It's 12 o'clock noon at the very center. You can plot where the minute hand is relative to noon along this axis. For example, if I click a bit early, and then I click a bit late, and then I click a bit late again, you get three data points plotted on the axis. We estimate the likelihood function from these data points with a dampened Parsing window estimator to achieve a continuous function like this red curve. This red curve is our estimation of the likelihood function. We can now compute the posterior distribution over all clocks using the likelihood and the prior. This distribution says how likely was a user targeting clock C given when they clicked. Nomon recalculates this distribution after every click and selects the clock C if its probability is greater than the 95% threshold. Now, a few questions arise concerning Nomon's real-life performance as a single-switch interface. These questions were the motivating factors behind our recent user study. First, what does a long-term learning curve for Nomon look like? As a more complicated interface than row-column scanning, how quickly can individuals learn to use Nomon effectively? More directly, given its theoretical advantages, can Nomon outperform row-column scanning in real-world text entry? We're also interested in how Nomon performs in applications beyond text entry, similar to the web page navigation example from before. And finally, having only been tested with able-bodied people, could Nomon be a feasible interface for individuals with motor impairments? To answer these, we conducted a longitudinal study comparing Nomon to row-column scanning. We followed 13 able-bodied participants across 10 sessions per user as they learned to use both Nomon and row-column scanning. As a first step towards answering this last question on Nomon's feasibility with its target population, we designed and validated a method to approximate motor-impaired operation of a single switch for use in our study. Being a vulnerable population, we wanted to ensure our methods were sound before diving into a study involving individuals with disabilities. However, we wanted to ensure that the data we collected was as representative of our target population as possible. Our approximation of motor-impaired switch operation is based on mimicking the reaction time distributions of actual switch users. We developed a noisy webcam-based switch to lower the reaction times of our participants down to levels more representative of the target population with motor impairments. In the top row of this graphic, you can see histograms of the reaction times of able-bodied users in blue and motor-impaired users in orange. Notice how the motor-impaired population tends to have a much longer reaction time than the able-bodied population. Here on the bottom row are histograms plotted on these exact same axes, but they are of the unhindered reaction times of our participants in blue and their lowered reaction times when using a noisy switch in orange. Notice how our noisy switch lowers participants' reaction times down to levels which are more in line with the data we have on our target population. We found that participants were continuing to improve with nomon up to the final session, while they stopped improving with row column scanning halfway through the study. We evaluated their performance in a text entry task in the final two sessions. Participants typed an average of 15% faster using nomon. We found no difference in error rates between the interfaces, though participants had a higher click load, meaning that they had to click more times per character using nomon. This suggests that there might be a trade-off between a faster click speed and a higher click load. In the final session, we asked participants to complete a task designed to simulate uses beyond text entry, particularly tasks with a large number of unordered uniform prior options. In order to have a direct comparison to row column scanning, we were limited to placing these options in a grid layout. However, you could imagine nomon working in a similar scenario as a web page with a comparable number of buttons and links. We found that nomon excelled in this task. Participants not only selected options 35% faster, but they did so with half as many corrections when using nomon. Finally, we collected subjective ratings and feedback from our participants throughout the study. In the final session, participants rated nomon as easier to use in row column scanning, and 12 out of 13 said they preferred typing with nomon over row column scanning. So to wrap up, nomon is very much in active development, and we are encouraging you to try out our keyboard demo here at this link. We would love your feedback as well if you have ideas, issues, or suggestions. We also have all of our code available as open source on our GitHub at this link. We see many directions and applications for nomon in the future, and we hope people can adapt our code and really explore new applications like web browsing and gaming. Right now, our focus is on a follow-up user study with a target population with motor impairments. We're currently recruiting participants and hope to have more data supporting nomon soon. If you're interested in the study or nomon in general, feel free to reach out to us at our email address. And if you have any questions or want to talk about nomon, I'll be available in poster session 3 and 4 on Thursday.